Okay, I guess that is working. Couldn't get the frames to stop dropping there at first, but we are live now. So it's time to say it.
Say it.
Welcome to Done Deal.
Welcome to Done Deal. What's going on, everybody out there?
In
I
studio
see you've
land.
changed the picture. So
Yes.
you've changed the picture a little bit. We're in
A little
color
bit,
now.
a little bit. I'm still not done with it because I actually have one that matches yours a little better, but I haven't managed to get it slotted in here yet.
I see the I guess we have a bigger budget for the show now.
How's that? I'm not following.
Oh, it's Tuesday. It's you know, it's we got more money allocated for the show. Our paychecks are bigger now, so we can afford better graphics
Oh, okay.
the
Just that's one of those checks I don't drop when it arrives, right? Because it might never stop bouncing.
True.
Yeah.
All
All
right,
right.
so
Give me a
what's going on,
sec.
everybody
I'm
out
gonna
there?
bring up some. What do you call it? I'm actually gonna bring up. I'm trying to bring up some music. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do it now after the fact, because XSplit's a little bit finicky about how it likes to work. I haven't seen chat yet, so that's totally your problem, Joe.
Yeah,
Go
they're
to chat.
screaming at you. They're like, Tiger, what the fuck is going on? They're
Yeah, okay.
going
Well,
crazy.
I
I'm
figured as
like,
much, But
you guys hear us? One's in the room if you can hear us. Okay, good. Beautiful. Thank you. Thank you. We get it. We get it. We get it.
right. Now, can they hear the music, or is that just me enjoying that all by myself?
Can you guys hear the music? One's in the room if you can hear the music. Not left one.
And I'm sorry, I know it's probably kind of loud. We'll get that sorted out too. Feedback, Jeff?
Oh, yes, everybody hears it. It's fine. Now it's too loud. Somebody said, now they say it's good.
Yeah. No, I had the levels all messed up. Everything has just been reset here, and there. Now we actually have cameras too. See? Just a matter of getting back in the saddle
Oh,
here.
I like that
It's
shirt. Where'd you get that
tricky
shirt
for
from?
me to, well, where I got this shirt from. It's tricky for me to actually do a broadcast at this hour because I know it's late for some of you. If you're out on East Coast, it's midnight now, and you have the kids in bed ages ago, and you're all settled. I'm on West Coast. My little guy just went to bed, and I've been running around like a crazy woman trying to get ready here. So here we are.
Yeah, well, the it's what you call it, the best coast.
West Coast, best coast, represent. See, I didn't even have my lip balm on yet. I get all lip balmed here. There we go. All right.
All right, so welcome to Done Deal, Vapor Joe's live here on the biggest network in vaping, Vaping Underground Live.
Yes,
I am
it
one of
is.
your hosts, Vapor Joe, and of course, I'm with the lovely, lovely Tyga Tyga.
That's really too kind tonight. It's a squirrely night. And oh, and that's so appropriate, following squirreling out. I'm having a squirrely night. Yes, looking sporty tonight. Thanks, Vapor's Break. That's about right. And yes, the Vapor
Awesome
Joe's
stuff.
shirt.
Yeah, that is great. I love that shirt. Except I have the same exact type of shirt, except I got the front in black and the sleeves in white, and I look like a penguin. It looked terrible. I can't wear it. I look terrible in
That's hilarious. That is utterly hilarious.
it.
Actually, mine is not a long sleeve. It's just a cap sleeve t-shirt, but I happen to think that just doesn't look that good on me, so I always wear the long sleeve under it and do the sleeve in sleeve thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. A bearded
So yes,
penguin.
I totally look like a penguin. Fucking horrible. So it has been a while for Done Deal, but what was going on with Done Deal was we were doing Done Deal right after Mod Envy, and you guys know how Mod Envy is. It's an insane show, and so doing Done Deal after Mod Envy started getting really taxing, and every night it was just like we were so tired after doing the show we could never get Done Deal done. So once we
But
found out Corey was going.
I was so reluctant to move it from Saturday because I know it being a later scheduled show, typically, you know, it is harder for people to be here during the week. But the opportunity presented itself, and we've just been so burned out on the Saturday night that
right.
You got to give this a shot. So
yeah. So we said, you know, once Corey said he was moving, he was taking a bit of a hiatus, I said, okay, well, let's move Done Deal to Tuesdays. And it was perfect because Tiger already had a show. I would love to do another show at a different day. And so I thought it was absolutely perfect. And we're going to light up Saturday night, I mean, Tuesday nights, because we come in after Scope Show, Squirreling Out, which is a huge show. So, you know, it's really, really good. And then after us comes DC.
That's right. Love and Vape says, Tiger, I thought you lived in Canada. I do. Canada has a West Coast, too.
Does it?
Yeah, absolutely. We have the same coast you do. As a matter of fact, we even have an extra one up north with lots of snow and ice and islands and stuff like that. So, polar bears, you know, the whole thing.
So, all right. So, let's get into, before we get, now, for those of you who haven't watched Done Deal, because we're probably going to get some new people in here. Done Deal does not do giveaways. We have zero giveaways. And that's weird, because we come from Mont Envy, which is like Deal City, but Done Deal doesn't do any giveaways. What we do is we give you the gift of Deal. That's what we do.
Right. That's right.
Oh, that was terrible. That was terrible.
That was really cheesy. I'm feeling a little queasy in my stomach right now, but, you know, we'll get through it. I've got my warm cocoa here to settle that. And and we shouldn't say never. You know, once in a blue moon, we just surprise you with something out of left field, and you just never know what's going to come up and what's going to get talked about and what deals we're going to throw at you. And
and sometimes even me and Tiger fight on air. It's awesome.
Love and Vape, both. I live in Canada on the West Coast. You're not the only Holy ones shit. With the West Coast, America.
Yeah, Love and Is it true you have, you know, it's like, do you have trees in Canada?
We have access to the Pacific Ocean too, just saying.
So for those of you who aren't used to this, basically we do do the deals of the week on my blog and Tiger's blog. We go over them and talk about them. Any bait mail we might have gotten. And of course, answer and question segments we have from the audience. Anybody who has any questions about, you know, atomizers or mods or what have you, you know, rumors or any kind of news that have come up, we are here to talk about it. So why don't we get into some bait mail? Now, Tiger, you have about 6 months worth of bait mail to talk about.
Well, not really, because I've been getting so little of it. I was, you know, before Christmas, I was doing all my Christmas shopping and getting stuff for that, and I wasn't buying any vape stuff. And then since Christmas, it's been just so little orders and so much stuff that I've been waiting and waiting and waiting on. So I did finally get some new things in, and I so wanted to have this in use for the show. I did not get the chance to wash it out. And that's the Subtank Mini. Now, you guys know from listening, at first I was like, what is the point? I don't get it. They've got a Subtank, they've got a Subtank Nano, they've got the Subtank Mini. What is this Mini about? What's the big deal? Well, the big deal is it's 22 millimeters, so it actually fits things properly, where the 25 is a little chunky on some stuff. I originally said, you know, for the difference in size, it's not worth the difference in tank. It'll hold so much less juice. Not really. It really doesn't hold much less juice at all. To the point now where they've discontinued the original Subtank and replaced it with the Subtank Plus, in fact. So the Mini, however, is carrying on. Now, I'm really impressed that this thing has shown up. The reason I didn't just fill it with juice is I'm getting a slight machine oil smell off that, so I didn't want to do anything with it until I had a chance to rinse it out, and that did not happen before the show. So, not in use, but I can hardly wait to fire that baby up. That's going to be a gooder, right, Joe? A gooder.
I hate that, a gooder.
Now,
let me question for you. You've tried the regular Subtank size, right?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I've got two of them in use on my desk right now. Hello, Subtank. Hello, super cool charm. Check out the super cool charm. If it would stop moving. Okay, it's a dove. It's a peace dove. And yeah, that's just really super cool. I love that. There we go.
I want a charm. I want some charm.
Hey, you gotta talk to Disneyland. she makes these, and I really like this one. So.
Cool. Anything else? Getting new mods in the last billion years, or?
Well, I've got a couple things on order, but they haven't arrived yet. Of course, I have that 50-watt iStick in play from the deal I ran. Now, they had a let me talk about that, because I know there's going to be some people here who've ordered that 50-watt iStick from my deal. I've been in contact with the supplier. He had some supply issues. His kits, the full kits, came in. So if you were one of the people that ordered the full kit, yours is already probably out the door long, you know, watch for it to show up. If you were like me and you ordered the mod only, there was a delay on those. So I'm getting tracking events showing now that mine's in motion. So it might be a little bit longer wait, but he's getting that squared away. So I understand. If anything changes, I'm going to let you know.
So she, yeah, so she's affected like everybody else. She's
yep.
Not special.
Yep, yep. That's sometimes the way the cookie crumbles. But hey, I got the best damn deal going. And, of course, the Zero mod, and I'll let you talk about that, but I've got one of those on its way as well. Now, remind me, Joe, is there anything I was supposed to talk about that came from you? I know I got a ton of juice this week. Oh my god, thank you. Juice Mafia sent me some beautiful samples, and that picture is up on Facebook on my timeline. For those of you who want to see, let me share. Grabbing a link. There we go. Find me here. And
didn't you buy another mod of Special Vape Slam Edition?
I certainly did, but again, all of these things are just in shipping. Now, those supposedly shipped today. I did get two of the beautiful copper Vape Slam Limited Edition from Red Dragon Mods. They had them on, and of course it was a deal. How could I resist, right? Regular 130. Regular 130 on for $50. And so I grabbed two of those, one for you.
Thank you, honey.
And Condensation, my Clouds bro from DC, is still on its way to me. I hope to see it later this week. I really expect it to show up later this week.
Okay.
Now, I don't know what happened to our volume there. That was very, very strange. The volume just kicked right out on the music. Do you guys hear that too? Did it just disappear for you too?
Well, I can't hear the music, but...
So weird. Yes, it... Okay, well, I don't know what happened. I didn't touch nothing, I promise. But I will fix it for you. I can do that. Let's find...
So while she's doing the music, I got, since the last done deal, I got 1,000 things, so I'm not going to bring them all up, but, the first thing, the most recent mod I got was from Tiger here. This is called Zero. This is a 50 watt, this has like a mother of pearl kind of inlay in it, and, it's a 50 watt box mod, it takes a single 18650, put the 18650 right there. Absolutely stunning, stunning device. This is, of course, a clone of the Zero. I got this, I believe she got this, did you get this on Fastech?
That's right from my deal.
Right, these are on Fastech for $58.88 at Tiger, oh, there it is, boom. Big Bam Boom in the room.
So thrilled. Let me explain. One of the biggest concerns and the biggest roadblocks I had moving this show to Tuesday nights was to make sure it would work for Big Bam, and I wasn't sure it would. We finally made the decision to do it because it was killing us, but I was so worried that we would not see as much or any of Big Bam Boobs, so it is such a treat to see you here. Thank you so much. And look at you so fast with the... Oh, I love you to bits. All right, continue,
okay,
Joe.
Okay, so back to the mod, and welcome, Big Bamboo. I'm very happy you're here, and I'm sorry you're half asleep. We will send you some Vivarin.
Joe's
so,
gonna
anyway,
send you coffee.
So again, like a mother of pearl inlay. Now, well, these can be pulled off, and you could put other other pieces on this if you want. They have wood, they have all kinds of stainless steel, copper, gold colors, all different patterns. It's absolutely stunning. Fantastic for the price. $58.88 for a 50-watt box mod. That is, in my opinion, one of the best I own. This is gorgeous. I've only had it for a couple days, but works without fail. I swear, not going to see this, but in front of the charging port right there, there are some letters. You're not going to see them, but I swear it says sex. In a strange font. I swear it says sex, which I'm okay with because Tiger sent this to me.
Oh my god.
Has the 510 is adjust. Somebody asked how the 510 is. The 510 is adjustable via a screw, so you can adjust that up and down. Works great.
Sean Max suggests you get a washing machine. they can't all be SX minis, Sean.
I know, for real. Now I got this bad boy over at Vapor Slam. This is a I call it the G-Prov or the GP, the G-Rov, GP-Rov, whatever you want to call it. This is a beautiful 26650 device. Uses an SX350 chip, 50 watt again. Beautiful Ace of Spades inlay on this. And it uses a single 26650. Really, really, really beautiful device. I've been using this like crazy. These were expensive. I paid at the meet, I paid $200 for this. But I have to tell you, for something that's handmade like this, it's not just, you know, a piece of metal. This guy made this by hand. It's wood. It's absolutely gorgeous. These aren't easy to get. I think he sold out. This is number 32 of the lot. Then I got this as a gift at Vapor Slam. This is a let me open it up first. This is a let me get this right. This is a BJ box, it's called, okay? Now you can't see this.
But
you can't really see it, but my face is literally laser engraved on this thing. And what this is I don't have any batteries in it right now, a dual 26650 device. The sled in there is 3D printed. It has a little, like the LED, display in there simply to see, you know, the voltage of the batteries. They are in parallel, so it's still a 4.2 volt device, but you're going to get, I don't know, 7,000 mAh out of it. Beautiful connector. And the button lights up when pushed. But I don't have any batteries in there right now to show you because they're charging. What else did I get? I got a K-Box. This is the Kanger K-Box. This is the new 40-watt device. Super cheap. They're like $24. Take a single 18650. These are wattage selectable, which means basically you go in and you select your wattage rather than like for instance, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I think 8 wattage selections. I think it goes 8, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, you know, like that. And basically how it works is you're going to see lights that pop up on here. Let me just show you. See those two lights?
Light.
Now one light is showing you, hold on, let me get it up there now. There it is. One light shows you battery level, one light shows you where your wattage level is. Right now my wattage level is at the lowest and the battery's almost dead because it's only at 2 bars.
But the nice part about that is, like we were talking about the big sub tanks, like to give you an idea, I mean, this is the FX Mini and you can see the sub tank is wider. You can see it. Come on, show me nice and clear. You can see that the 510 connection there is a little smaller, just a smidgen smaller than the base of the sub tank. That puppy is made for the sub tank.
Right. Absolutely meant for the large sub tank. And of course, I don't think I brought this up unless a done deal. I got a Klauper 30 watt. This is a little guy. He's only 30 watts. He's really cheap. Takes a single 18650. Just magnetic door, just like that. Works like a charm. I like it better than the iStick version, simply because I could change the battery up. They're about the same price. But I do like this one a little bit better. I like the box shape of it. I thought that was, you know, for the price, I think it was like, you know, $31 or something. But I've had no problem.
Didn't catch that. Joe prefers box shape.
Yeah, I love boxes. Just saying. Okay. Now, since we were talking about the Kanger, I think it was the Kanger Plus, Subtank Plus, I actually found a guy who's got him in stock right now. Let me put a link in the room if Big Bamboo doesn't beat me to it. Oh, I got it.
Don't count on it. Even half asleep, basic, Big Bam is fast.
The Kanger, now what this is they basically got rid of the 7mm Subtank and made the Mini and the Nano. And then they made the larger, which is this one on here, a Plus. And what the Plus is, it's slightly different. It's completely redesigned airflow on the bottom, because you can see now it has that huge slot, like almost like an aero tank. And from what I understand, when you're using the rebuildable, you don't have to put in a chimney and all this other crap to make the rebuildable work. It just works. Much like the regular head. So you don't have to do, so you don't lose any liquid that's in the tank, because the original Subtank, when you put the chimney in and the rebuildable, you lost about 2 mils worth of juice in space with all the stuff. So, and the cool thing is it uses the same heads. So you don't have to buy all new heads for this one. It uses the same one. So you get over at Vapor DNA for $35.99 with the coupon code, and every order at Vapor DNA, you get a free 10 mil bottle of juice. And I love the guys over at Vapor DNA. If you guys are looking for one, there you go. And I think that's pretty much it as far as my vape mail is concerned.
That's it. We're all vape mailed out. I didn't get to mention that I also got a huge juice package, and I did want to give them a shout out from Redux Vapors in Calgary. Thank you to Jason and Pixie for sending that out for me. I've been trying a few of them. And the spearmint gum was yesterday, I think it's called Crater. It's a nice, it reminds me exactly of the green sticks of gum, you know. Well, the gum itself wasn't green, but the package was. And yeah, pretty nice and fresh. Today we're on Tricycle, which is a fruity blend.
Tricycle.
And you know me, I can't identify what fruit, I just know it's fruity, so. Anyway.
It's a mixed fruit.
It's a mixed fruit.
It's a fruit medley.
It is that. So thank you very much to Redux for those samples, and I will get into more of them as the week progresses. Well, I guess we can talk about some deals, unless there was any news you wanted to share. Is there any news? News, Joe? News?
I'm thinking.
You're thinking? While you think, bear with me, because I haven't built our feature screen. My presentation was all screwed up when I sat down here, so I'm kind of rebuilding as I go. So Joe will talk, and I will work.
Oh, well, in that case, there's actually really no new news. I'm looking at the screen I banished. Tiger's just taking me out of the picture.
No. That's one of the things I'm adding, Joe.
I'm kidding. there's really no news, because it's all vape meets now. You know, you got ECC coming up, Vape Expo, and we had Vapor Slam, and then VCCPA is coming up, and then you got Vape Mania coming up, you got Bash coming up, and you got all this stuff coming up. So there's all the news will come from the vape meets. So what happens is, nobody's going to break any news until, say, like ECC, you know, Vape Expo. That's when you'll see new news come out. And then after that, the next big vape meet, that's when news will come out. But as far as, the only news I saw was that picture floating around with that dude with the lab with the toilet bowl. You see this?
I don't believe I did.
It was all over Facebook. I don't know if this is real, but I'm just throwing it out there because I thought it was disgusting. But I'm going to put a picture of it in the room. Some people said this was a setup. Some people said blah, blah, blah. But I'm going to put a picture of this in the room. And basically, somebody took this picture, and apparently, from what I understand, it was a disgruntled employee that took a picture of this guy's lab. And it happens to have a toilet bowl in the lab. And,
I did see that.
Somebody said that was a setup. The guy just put stuff in there and took the picture, but what is that On the cabinet, there is a little unit. I don't know what that unit is. Is that like a sterilizing device? What is that? Anybody know? Anybody in the room know what that little unit is? It's right up on top of the cabinet. It looks like if it was, and if it didn't have that display, I'd say it was a mini refrigerator, but it's not.
But it's not.
It looks like a dishwasher, somebody says. Okay, Abby says it looks like a dishwasher. Or steeper. Okay. Anyway, so that was this person's use. I don't know whose this is, but Smokey was pimping it everywhere, and I saw it, and I was just like, oh my god, talk about the worst possible press in the world for any juice maker ever. But, that's about the only funny, weird, disgusting, strange news coming out of anything, really. It's been pretty quiet in the vaping community as far as drama, as far as anything new coming. I know, Tiger, you were talking about some guy who's coming out with something new tomorrow.
Tomorrow? The second.
Yeah, you sent me a picture, a Facebook page of that guy. It wasn't a guy, it was a company.
Yeah, no, they said they're releasing that on April 15th. Now, I don't know if you have the link, because now you've talked about it. You better produce a link, Joe.
Yeah, I'm going to find it.
And, yeah, I can't go look for it right now. Sorry! You're on your own.
Yep, I'm going to do that now. Yep, no problem. I will find it. It's in our Skype chat somewhere.
Oh, see, now look, they're looking on the bright side. They're saying at least the toilet looks clean, though.
Actually, unveiling was 4/1/15. It was today. It's today it's coming out, actually.
4/1. Oh, I read it wrong. I saw the 15 and messed it all up in my head to make it April 15. Okay, so today. Ooh, there you go.
Yeah, there's this company coming out called Alder Industries. Adler Industries, and they keep showing these pictures of basically there's a big X between, you know, the post for where you wick and I guess the airflow of an Addy with juice coming out of it, saying that juice always spits out of it. And they're saying something is gonna be completely different, something's coming. And it's supposed to be today, apparently, because it is the 1st of April. Oh, by the way, happy April Fools. So I'm not sure what they're going to do, but it says basically big things come in small packages, 4/1/15 at 1 p.m.
At 1 p.m. Okay, so that at 1 p.m., you see, you can only pull jokes until noon, so that tells me they actually mean to release something, and this isn't just hype and a joke. We shall find out.
Well, we'll see. It could be a launch of an April Fool's show. It could be a launch of something incredible. But I don't know. Would you put all that, you know, time and effort into making this idea and then not, you know what I mean?
I don't know. It could go either way, but because they chose 1 p.m., I'm hoping that means they're on the level and serious, because if you pull an April Fool's joke afternoon, you're the fool.
Oh, is that how it works?
Yeah, you only have to
get on it.
Yeah, yeah, I think actually it's over before you're awake.
Hey, I did it last year. I did the DNA 30 has been cloned. Post, and I linked, and everybody's like, oh my god, really, blah, 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 and linked to a big piece of plastic poo on FASTEC.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody got really angry with me, but it was actually kind of funny.
Well, I do have something to show that has finally, I mean, let me, okay, we'll drop the link, and then let's see if I can add a picture. I think we have the technology. Screen capture. Grab this. Doot. Doot. And there we go. Oh, look at that. We got pictures. we have been talking about this and waiting and anticipating for ages and ages and ages and ages, and now finally, finally, we are seeing them available for sale. And I know our own dear and darling Tammy has been really stoked about this one finally showing up. So they were sort of informally calling this the Shell Mod. The correct name that you can search by seems to be F1998, which sounds more like a truck model to me, but, you know, yeah. It's a mod. And it is an 18650 tube mod, bottom firing switch, primarily stainless steel construction with, of course, the beautiful POWA shell inserts, or POWA, however you say that. And so many different designs and colors. We'll have to wait and see what finally makes it to the hands of retailers. These are on Alibaba right now, so it's not easy for an individual to grab one. It's not impossible. Some of them do have MOQs, you know, minimum order quantities of as low as one unit. Mm-hmm. So, but you will have to sort of go back and forth and fiddle around to find shipping costs and get it all settled if you want to go that route. Not impossible, just not necessarily easy. But now that they're there, watch for resellers to get them, and we'll continue monitoring it and letting you know where to find them. But I was just excited to see they're finally available. Yay! Pretty, pretty.
They look nice. Yeah, totally a chick mod, though. Totally a chick mod. Actually, I would rock the green. I would rock the green one.
Absolutely. Any of those colors, maybe. Okay, well, you'd have to be a secure guy to rock the purple. But, you know, there's guys who can. So.
Babography would rock the purple one. He has a crazy purple convict.
Mm.
And he rocks that like no other. So, mm-hmm. And he let me lick his face at Vapor Slam. So he's very, very
He's very secure. All right.
All right, so what else you got, Tiger? Tiger?
What else I got? I got something else. I got, you know, if you do manage to get your hands on one of these beautiful puppies, you're going to need some good batteries to put in it, and these are some of the best. Good price on these, too. They end up coming in at $519 a piece. So that is an excellent price on what is largely considered one of the best batteries available currently.
Right.
Now these ones, I think the amp rating on them is 20 amps continuous. So personally, I wouldn't go crazy low on these. Don't sub ohm maybe, but certainly for the majority of low resistance builds, these are going to be terrific batteries. And the techs among us are telling us these are great. So $519 a piece, free shipping, yay. And here's the nice thing. We headlined this one, Guess Who's Shipping Batteries Again. Some of our favorite overseas vendors had kind of ceased doing that. It was getting difficult for them to ship. They're back at it. And the great news for America, not so good for me, but oh well, for America, they have added an express shipping option for the batteries. Should have them at your door within 12 days. So,
right. It's called a USPS Expedited for Battery Products. Okay.
Right.
It's 30 cents extra. So basically, Fastech is shipping batteries again. And we've all been buying batteries, you know, Fastech hasn't shipped batteries in a long time because there were huge problems. Well, they have procured a shipping method via the U.S. Postal Service, for America at least. Now, I do see they do it via Sweden Post too, Tiger, so that may work for Canada.
Oh, we can get them. It's just sort of, there's really only one option for us. I think, is it Malaysia Post? And it'll take a while. They're pretty much telling us, you know, hang in there. It's coming, but you're going to have to wait. Now, you know me, for a good deal, I can be very, very patient, like zen patient. So,
yeah, she is, trust me. and also, you know, anytime you're buying any battery product at Fastech, coupon code BLF will always give you 10% off.
That's chargers, in the post as well. The link that Bam and I shared has that there for you.
Right. So anything, but that includes flashlights, chargers, anything battery related. I don't think egos, But anything that uses, anything that's in that kind of battery, flashlight, charger category, you'll get 10% off with a coupon. It's been there forever, so it's never gonna go away, I don't think. All right, so.
All right.
I got a deal. Now, this is old school, okay? I know this is funny, you're probably gonna laugh, but it's old school. It's the Aspire Vivi Nova. Now, who the hell wants a Vivi Nova, right? And Vivi, it's so old, right? But I tell you, for the price, this is not the old school Vision Vivi Novas. These are made by Aspire, and they're bottom coil Vivi Novas. They're not the ones that have the long wicks that came from the top. So they're a little bit more updated version, but they're shipping from Vapor Beast out of America for $1.77 a piece. Now, okay, am I running out to buy Vivi Novas now? No. Will I buy them for new vapors? Would I buy them for a backup? Throw in my car? Something? Definitely for that price. I'd buy 10, you know, and just keep them in my closet. Or like I said, you know, it's probably the simplest fill and vape money you can buy for the price. You know what I mean? Now, these are disposable, so once the head dies, you just chuck it in the garbage. Oh, we know we're not used to that, but, you know, back in the day, these cost, you know, $7-$8 a piece. You know, what say you, Tiger?
You know, it's not something I'll be rushing out to get, but what I would consider doing is having a few of these on hand for newbies. I mean, at that price, you can afford to put one in somebody's hands and say, try this vaping thing. Put away the cancer sticks. I love having stuff on hand that's easy to use, easy to fill, easy to give away.
And they're bottom dual coil, Vivi Novas. Okay, so again, these aren't the Vivi Novas we're used to when they first came out. These are basically the redesign, the last ditch effort to keep the Vivi Nova alive before they started moving into things like, you know, your Pro Tanks, your Pro Tank 2s and 3s. So, I mean, this is about a year old product, but again, very much worth $1.77 a piece. You know, definitely worth checking out if you want to just pick up something quick and easy for a new vapor, something easy for them to understand. Because, you know, got to remember, new vapors don't understand replaceable heads and things. They just want to fill it and vape it and go, oh, this tastes like shit now. Okay, I could just throw it in the garbage. Let me get the other one, you know.
and that's the other thing they're nice for, too, for us. I mean, there are places I go where you don't want to bring your best stuff. You know, you're going to the park with your kid or something like that, and you want to have something in your pocket. And I like having something that if it does fall out of my pocket and, you know, get full of sand or break or something, it's like, so what, you know?
Oh, no, I lost my Vivi Nova.
Yeah, exactly. My $1.77 Vivi Nova. You know, no big deal. So sometimes those are just handy to have on hand for those moments you don't want to have your best stuff on you.
Yep. So that's just a little, you know, I put up a ton of deals today. Usually I only put up 3 or 4 today. I did, I think, 6. And I just saw that. I just had to throw it up there. Yeah, I was in the deal zone today.
In the deal zone.
Okay, so Tiger, what you got next, girl?
What I got next? All right. You're just moving right along, aren't you? Horizon. Now, there's legal doings surrounding this one. So let's cover the buzz first. The buzz is that Aspire is suing Horizon about this Arctic tank. I guess they don't like that it can use the coils. I don't know what the problem is, or they beat them to an idea. In any case, I'm hearing there is a lawsuit in place. And Horizon can produce no more of these until this is cleared up. That doesn't stop the ones that are already out there. And
that won't stop the clones.
What's that?
And it won't stop the clones.
Oh, no, there's no stopping that, ever. We know that. But these are the authentic Horizon Arctic tank. Now, I don't have one yet. I've got one of these on order. There is a little delay in the shipping on these while they're fulfilling. But I haven't heard that these will not ship. So hopefully this is not affected by this lawsuit. And I'm hearing from users that of all of the sub-ohming ready to rock and roll tanks out there, no rebuilding required, that the Arctic seems to be the favorite. Which is pretty impressive to me. I mean, when I got my Atlantis, I was impressed. When I got my sub tank, I was more impressed. But the Arctic seems to be winning people over, so I can hardly wait to get my hands on one and see what I think. But there you have it.
Well, don't forget, the Arctic goes, has head that goes to 0.2 ohms.
That's right. That's right. They are lower than the others are currently making available. Right.
So we're getting to the place now where you definitely need a serious battery.
Yes. They do say that these are, you know, that it's okay to fire these up to 100 watts. Now, I would say anything getting into the real high ranges, you want to make sure you're, you know, the right battery, the right mod, the right juice. Not all juices are meant to be vaped at 100 watts, okay? Just some of them just do not hold up. But in any case, yeah, 0.2 ohm heads ready to rock and roll.
Yeah, that's just... That's freaking, that's crazy. I mean, I, you know, 0.5, I mean, I'm vaping on the 0.5s at 35 watts, and it's perfect for me. 0.2s would just be, you know, even, you know, I'm really excited to try it, to be honest with you. Because we're all used to 0.2, but say on a dripper, right? And,
oh,
you know,
yeah.
You gotta kind of, and you gotta kind of keep refilling, because 0.2 is gonna burn up that juice quick. So you're, you know, every three or four vape pulls, you're refilling it. You know, picture that on a 7mm tank. You know, because nobody's rocking a K-Fun at 0.2. You know what I mean? So now you're actually getting into an area where dripping, it's competing with dripping now. Because now you're at that such a low ohm, and you're going to get the clouds, and now you've got a huge tank. So you don't have to worry about, you know, redoing your wick every three or four pulls. Just, you know, it depends on how the coil is. I don't know how, you know, if they taste as good as dripping, it's usually not the case, but it's getting close.
Well,
it's getting close.
They're closing the gap, and that's really what it is. A lot of drippers now find there is no reason to drip and drive anymore because they can take something like this, find it very, very satisfying while they're out, and switch back to their drippers when they're comfortably at their desk or on their couch or wherever they like to spend their time.
Right. Right, you have it. Let's see if there's anybody talking in the room for just a second.
What?
Just seeing if anybody in the room has actually used one.
Ah.
Has anybody here ever actually used one of these yet? Alright, Nate, how are they? Have you tried to point two well in the heads yet, buddy? And yeah, Toxic Angel's like, loving it.
Rock on, B. Damn well as an Arctic. Well,
but
yeah,
Nate,
I imagine
out.
It's going to go through the juice quick with that more aggressive built head. Yep. Ashley's tried one.
Coils last 3 weeks? Wow, that's incredible.
Toxic Angel is saying it outdoes the Kanger and Atlantis in her opinion. Hmm? So another one that's consistent with what I'm hearing.
So we shall see. We shall see. All right, let's see.
Over to you, Joe.
Over to you, Joe.
And I'm sorry, I don't have pictures for your stuff queued up tonight. We'll have to collaborate ahead of time.
No problem at all. So this is called, now this is a little neat idea. This is called the Aspire CF Sub-Ohm Battery. Now, it looks, it's not an ego battery. What this is basically a, picture a mechanical and a regulated kind of just mushed together. It's basically a single push device, a single button, okay? But it's capable of 40 amps and going down to 0.3 ohms, okay?
What?
Well, this was originally, are you okay?
Oh yeah, just having mod dominoes, nothing.
What this was originally built for was the Atlantis at 0.5 ohms. So basically, you would just marry this push button bit tube mod with the Atlantis, and it would fire it at 4.2 volts at a maximum of 40 amps. So basically, it would be like hitting it with a mechanical mod. But you could use anything down to 0.3 ohms on this thing. Shit, you could use a dripper if you have it at 0.3 ohms. Cool thing is, it has an internal resistance, an internal mod of 2,000, and again, it lasts anywhere, they say, if you're using it hardcore, 2 to 5 hours. But it's just a simple push button, done, out the door. It's $27.99. It's extremely cheap because everybody else, every sewing is for about $39.99. Sun Vapors has them at $27 on sale. I bought one today because I hit this at Slam with, that sounded terrible. I hit this at Slam with a sub-tank on it, and it blew my mind. I'm like, this is like a fat eco battery. How is it doing this? And this is the new tech that they're doing. They're pushing higher amperage to make this, give it a good punch, allow it to push those really, really low ohm heads. Really nice. I'm going to keep this in my truck. This is going to be my permanent mod that I keep in my truck. I don't have to bring out big old, you know, chunky, hunky box mods. This just sits in the glove compartment or in the center console. All I got to do is bring a tank with me and I'm good to go. How do you charge it? There's a. It's like an ego charger that comes with it, or no, it doesn't come with it. It's like an ego charger. Basically, it screws in. Now, have you heard of these, Tiger?
Oh yeah. Yeah, I think I've run them at one time or another. Not this particular deal. You did.
Right. Now there's another version of this that takes an 18650. Those are a little bit more expensive. These come with their own battery and built in. So. $27. I thought it was pretty cool. I threw it up there. As people seem to be taking to it a little bit, I bought one just to see what it's like.
Now I'm not sure if Toxic Angel's saying this, talking about the same thing, but she's saying it comes to $19.98, a total of 59.2% off. What?
Enter what code?
Oh, that's for her sale? My apologies. Confused. Talking about different things.
Okay. Gotcha. Toxic, are you selling these batteries for $19.98?
No. We crossed wires.
Okay. No big deal. Okay, my bad. Because I was, I'll put the post up now.
Yeah, you won't even wait till the end of the show, seriously.
All right. So speaking of regulation, Tiger.
Speaking of regulation, I got a new one that's come out, and this one ships from the States, so that's kind of a treat because you don't have to wait. And that is the Aspire ESP. This is a 30 watt, so we're not talking crazy high wattage here, you know. But I mean, it's not that many months ago that 30 watts was still a really big deal. And the reality is, most vapors, statistically speaking, still aren't breaking 20 watts. So 30 is lots. This one's got a kind of a pleasing and unique shape. We haven't seen this before. And I love the carbon fiber look to it, the crisp, clean display, and the ease with which you can adjust your wattage. It's let me just come over here. And this dial right here, right on the top, you just turn it to adjust your wattage. Now, how easy is that? No fooling with buttons or gravity things where you're tipping it and overshooting it, and single button displays where you're trying to figure out, how do I get in there? How many clicks is this and how many clicks is that? So many of my mods, I'm not technologically maimed or anything like that, but I'm a little bit of a technodolt at times, and you get things set up and then you forget how you did it and you go to change it and it's like, how the hell? I mean, so how easy is that? Turn it up, turn it down. There you go.
You know, that wheel design, the Darwin actually was the original launch device. Didn't have that kind of wheel, but it used a wheel style where you used a potentiometer or whatever they call it, where you just have that wheel and you turn it up and down. And I find them, I like them better. Am I drinking out of a 2-liter bottle? Yes, I am. What? Can I be my Diet Coke? What's the problem? Got a problem?
In his hand, it looks like a 1-liter. And Big Bam, that's a very good question. To be really honest, I don't know the answer to that one. We'd have to check into it, asking if the device can be locked. Now, I would want to believe so, but I can't say that for certain.
Usually it's a 3-click. Most of the time, especially with a button like that, you're definitely going to need a lock. I'm sure it has a 3-click on and off.
Well, not merely an on-off, but to lock the wattage in place so that you can't bump it up and down. And the truth is, yeah, I'm just not sure. You'd have to look into that. But USB charging, as most things are now. and kind of a cool looking. I love that carbon fiber. I'm mad about carbon fiber. So there you go.
Yeah, nice looking device. Again, made by Aspire. Yep. So we're in a kind of an Aspire mode right now.
A little bit. They got a lot of things going on.
And now, don't forget, if you buy this, you'll also get a free bottle of juice.
Oh, that's right. Vapor DNA says that. Now, I do have... Let's switch gears and talk about a mechanical. Because we've talked about a few regulated... Whoops. Okay, how did I get out of there? We've talked about a few regulated devices now, and I'd like to move into a really hot mechanical. That's the Black Oak. This is the Black Oak styled. It takes a 26650 battery, and they've done something rather unique. Now let me walk you through it. This cage right here on the outside, or well, it's technically I guess the inside, houses your atomizer. So we're kind of back to the VTR was the first to do this, to kind of house your atomizer down inside the mod with a cage to protect it. The Black Oak is doing essentially the same thing, but with so much more style and panache. What if you want to use a really, really tall, like a full K-Fun or something like that? No problem. You can just put it directly down inside and your drip tip is up here, ready for you to vape. But what if you want to use something shorter, say a Jenny? You can use one of the smaller spacers here to go into the tube first. Well, you put it on the atomizer and then screw that whole assembly down into the cage. With the tallest one, you can even put a dripper in there if you want to. But it sits down inside the mod, really neat, clean look. It comes with the Black Oak stand as well, and everything is done up in a beautiful hinged box. So now, the really cool part about this is at $44.95, this deal is coming in at less, read my lips, less than half the price of FastTech. Now, when you can beat FastTech by more than 50%, you're playing for keeps. So, grab these while you can. It is a limited time special. It's a promotional group buy they're running. Now, I forget exactly what day these are estimated to ship. So, get in on it quick before that deal is over. Now, I checked this afternoon. It's still going strong. So.
You have You have 11 hours left, and it's ETA on shipping. It's April 3rd.
There you go.
Now, also, don't forget the copper pins. It comes with four copper pins. Now, basically, what you're going to do, I think, the way I look at this, is as you add those spacers, you change the pin. And they come with these really beautiful, pure copper pins that you put down in through the spacer that you lock in. So, basically, what happens is, instead of... What they did was very smart. Instead of taking a keeping the firing pin on the bottom and then adding a spacer, then adding another spacer, all that shit does is lose voltage. What they do is basically as you add the spacer, you put the pin down in it and lock it in through the spacers to the bottom, so you still have that, you don't have that voltage loss that you would if it was just things stacked up on top of each other. So I thought that was a really, really cool idea. And it's gorgeous, and it comes with its own mod stand.
And of course, so I thought that was trim right on the mod itself at the bottom there, where it gets its name. So there you go, Black Oak, less than 50%, or well, more than 50% off one of the cheapest sources. So, big deal.
All right, let's talk drippers now. This one, I'm gonna see if it's if this is still up and running. Yes, it is. It's still in stock. This is called the Igo W6. This has been out a little while. We're looking at solid 4 or 5 months this has been out. These were expensive. These were going for about $40 a piece. These are authentic. These aren't knockoffs. Shipping from Vapor DNA for just $8.97. Now, I saw a Rip Tripper video with this, and this thing's insane. I mean, you could put like 8 coils on this thing. All kinds of crazy airflow and all kinds of crazy stuff you can do with this thing. And it has what they have a new and improved center pin. The originals they had, there was an issue. They've changed them. And he has, I don't know, how many does he have left right now? Take a look. I don't know if there's a number. But No, there's no number involved. But at $8.97, you can't go wrong. I mean, you can't get this. You can't get the clone at Fastech for $8.97. So it's just a really cool dribber. I'm sorry. Did I say Vapor DNA? I meant Vapor Beast.
My bad.
Yeah, it's definitely not for an amateur. Now, Tiger, I don't know if you've ever used a dripper like this where you have to literally center post it 8 times and all kinds of crazy stuff.
No, I haven't. I know the W6, you know, it is intimidating, Rusty, but really it's just the same thing as any other dripper, except you've just got a lot more possibilities, really. Right. You know, all those negative posts. That doesn't lock you into using them all. Bear in mind, you can still just build a dual coil if you want to, but you have the option of doing all the wild and crazy stuff with that baby.
Yeah, just type IGO-W6 in Google and then look at the images. You'll see the crazy fucking coils people have made off this thing.
Yeah.
I mean, just insanity.
Lots of YouTube videos available to walk you through the build.
Now, if you own a brick and mortar, there's a lot of resale value in this deal too. Don't forget about that, because I know we have vendors here that own brick and mortars. You know, buy 20 of them, and you can easily sell these for $19.99 a piece in your brick and mortar. You know, make some profit out the door. I buy things like this for giveaways. When I see deals like this, I'll buy 10 or 20 of them. So when I do giveaways on people's show, I got it at a great deal. But they're getting an awesome addy. When the IGO W4s and the 3s went up for like $6 or $7, I bought like 10 and 20 of each. Just for the random giveaways I do on the shows, some of the shows with you live. So if you're looking for something, and this is a challenge too, don't forget. I mean, it does look intimidating, but if you could build this, some of the newer drippers are going to be a breeze.
Oh, yeah.
So.
Now, Big Bam had a good thought when we were talking about news. We probably should have talked about, you passed a couple major milestones this week. One of them being the 3,000th post, and
yes.
The other one being 52 million.
Million. Yeah, 3,000 posts. Now, that doesn't sound like much, but if you think about it, as much as I've been around and I blabber, you know, I told Smokey, hit me up, he's like, that's it? Only 3,000 posts? I'm like, well, yeah, it's a year and a half, 3 posts a day, times 365, that's like 1,000 a year, times 2.5 years, it's like 3,000 posts. And he's like, oh man, I didn't even think about it. I'm like, yeah, it's, you know, but 3,000 of them, that's a lot to do, honestly, because that's 3,000 researchers and 3,000 of going out and finding these deals and doing all this stuff. It gets crazy. And of course, the hits, well, yes, this week, it's been crazy. I've been averaging about 120,000 hits per day on Vapor Joes, which has been really, I mean, since the post itself, I've gotten almost 400,000 hits since, when was it? Since the 28th, I've gotten 400,000 hits. So my next million will be probably end of the week. So, you know, so it's been really crazy.
Oh, Callie Claw, I'm delighted to hear that. That is some of the most exciting stuff we get to hear from you guys. Callie Claw says, I saved many times with your help. That's what we're here for. Yay.
Damn straight. You know, people don't know this, but when I bought my first kit, when I started vaping, I paid $159 for an eco kit. From a reputable vendor. This isn't like some shitty, you know, back alley vendor. This is from Vapor Kings. They are a known vendor. They've been around forever. They're great people. But back then, there was really no competition. No place to show people where you get the deals. Now.
And Big Bam, I think probably the reason he didn't focus on that post in particular is because I think that one sold out. Did it not, Joe?
Oh yeah, the Big Bam, that sold out. 2 auctions sold out. We could talk about it though while you're here. Basically, there's 2 people on eBay. Basically, I started out at $11 each. Basically, it's a replaceable, rebuildable head for the Atlantis. So everybody jumped on it. He had 70 that sold out within like a half an hour. Then I found another guy who was actually cheaper at $9.99. He had about 100 of them. No, 45 of them. They sold out in like 15 minutes. So I was it just blew out so fast, and I'm kind of upset about it because I wish these guys had more, but you can't really tell the quantity they have on eBay. Like, you can't, it'll say more than 10, so you hope, that they have 1,000. But it was a really good deal, and everybody jumped on it. Like, that was crazy. So, yeah, that's why I didn't talk about it, because that was talking about.
Well, I'm just catching up on chat here again. FreakMax says, yeah, but screw you guys for taking all my spending money as well. Well, I'm sorry, FreakMax. If it's any consolation at all, know that it's just as hard on us. We get first crack at all these deals. And believe you me, I can fill a lot of shopping carts. And I got to show you something that went in my cart very, very quickly. Like, I mean, I made sure I paid for mine before I shared this with you guys.
Yes, I do occasionally do that.
What?
Is this your next deal?
It is.
I just, my mouth opened. On the replay, you're going to see my jaw drop when I just saw this. I never seen this mod yet.
Oh my gosh. Now, I warn you, the price in the picture is wrong. Since we published this, the post has been updated, but since we published, the price went up to, you know, like 58 cents. Okay, big deal. But it's now $37.57 because that is the lowest Ivogo would let them sell it for. They quibbled over 58 cents, so these guys had to comply in order to keep selling them. This is the Cherry Bomber replica, and it is gorgeous.
Yeah,
I couldn't resist. I snapped mine up before I hit publish because I did not want to miss out.
Now, is that, what's her name from Who Framed Roger Rabbit? Is that
Think it's not really Jessica Rabbit, but it certainly is reminiscent of her. It's definitely inspired by, but this is the artwork that is on the original as well. The engraving is you know, it's a clone, you know? So, now, I did include a link at the bottom of my post. I'll just drop that in there again. If you prefer a black finish, there is another supplier that has the silver and the black. Now, if you're interested in the aluminum, like I was, I would strongly suggest... what is going on here now? I'm not sure. Are we still up, guys?
Yeah, we're up.
Oh, okay, because my feed just dropped. Probably just a computer problem. But if you're interested in the aluminum, I would go with this first deal because my understanding is it's going to ship sooner. The second link does have both the aluminum and the black, but I think they're going to take longer to ship. So the choice is yours. You got options.
Wow, that's crazy. That's a gorgeous mod.
Condensation says the engraving is Tiger Tiger. He called Focal and they verified. I wish. But that's all I'll say about that. But yeah, I love this one. And of course, the dual 18650. This is a pure mechanical box, but just beautifully executed.
Wow, this is absolutely great. I'm just blown away by it. It's so beautiful.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, I know there's a lot of folks who are waiting for the black to come out and really anticipating that. For me, in all fairness, I think the black kind of wrecks it because the engravings just don't pop. You know, in the aluminum, it's drop-dead gorgeous.
If there was a way to get the black but somehow take the engraving and get red in there...
Well, even engraving, if it was a black finish on aluminum and engraving down into the aluminum, would look pretty deadly. But, you know, it is what it is. So. All right. Well, let's see here. We are at 10:06. We have got 24 minutes left on the clock.
Quick.
Joe, over to you.
New design I want to talk about. It's called the KSRTA. This isn't like a K-Fun style, but it's different. Let me put that in the room. It's just pictures. The guy's gonna want 140 for this, but this is a legit version. I'm sure it's gonna get cloned at some point. But the cool thing about this is now he has no pictures of the deck yet, but it's built and it's ready to go. I didn't get any pictures of the deck. The coolest part about this one, it's built, I think, basically for a box mod. It really shows how box mods have taken over. Couldn't put this on a tube mod if you wanted to. I mean, well, if you wanted to, it would just look terrible if you did. But the coolest thing I like, the fill hole on this thing. You just unscrew it, fill it up, screw it back on, you're done. that is what I love about this thing. And I think it looks pretty badass. It's in a, you know, that's the one thing I like about the community. Not everybody has stopped innovating. Now, Tiger, I don't know what you think about it. Some people actually think it's ugly. What do you think?
Yo, I can't click the link. Sorry, babe.
Oh, sorry. Okay, well, it's, all right, let me look at the room. What does everybody in the room think? Yeah, it's interesting looking. Yeah, basically, Tiger, it's an, well, I can't even explain the shape of it. It's so hard to explain. You've seen it. It's been around the blogosphere. Anyway, so that's something new. Is that a clone? No, these are brand new. They just came out. It's guy wants 140 apiece for him, which is expensive. But let's face it, you know, it's the first run. That's the way it's going to be. And then, you know, I'm sure Fast Tech or some other company is going to go and clone it and probably charge you $20 for it. But for right now, if you're looking for it, I think there's a group buy going on Facebook. I believe it's in my group, Favorite Joe's. So, and that's it. Just some innovation. All right, Tiger, you still have a few left.
I do. I have another dripper I wanted to talk about, and that I was pretty excited when I saw come out. Because I already told you earlier in the show, I'm crazy about carbon fiber. And I have been waiting and watching and anxiously anticipating grabbing one of these Dark Horse styles. I'm hearing great things about them. That really, really well-respected dripper, great flavor, tons of vapor production, depending, of course, how you build it and run it. But the potential is there. I love the styling of the Dark Horse. But I wanted to make sure I got one with good, sturdy negative posts really, really well. Now, nobody is saying these ones are milled in, and the pictures are just not quite good enough to assure me, but I gotta say, these ones look like the milled in posts, and that is a bonus. They're not gonna spin, they're not gonna turn, they're not gonna loosen up. Now, until I have it in my hand, I'm not going to say that for sure, but I got to say, you know, compared to a lot of the other pictures of these I've seen, these ones look like they might be the real deal. And so for under $10, I'm going to take the chance and find out. I've got one in my cart right now, and I love the colors. Available in 5 colors. There's a light silver, a gray, a black, a blue, and a red. And right. And of course, the Delrin top piece to that cap. Now, that's really brilliant because that's going to insulate your drip tip and help keep things a little cooler. So I'm pretty stoked. Great big drilled holes in these posts. So you can use your great big thick wire or your twisted wire or your crazy Clapton coil wire or however you want to do it. You got options. And of course, right. All with that beautiful carbon fiber airflow control ring.
Right, I remember I was in a hangout with, I forget who it was, but they love their Dark Horses. Oh, I love my Dark Horse. Oh my god, they have one in, you know, carbon fiber. I have to buy it. I have to get it. Shit, it's on pre-order. I can't get it yet. But now they're out and you can buy them and they're going to ship. But it says ships in less than 5 days. I don't know. The carbon fiber just does something to it. It makes everything pop. And I like the screws on these big honking Phillips head screws, which makes building a little easier. I'm not a fan, even though I'm not an avid rebuilder. Everybody knows it. I hate the Allen key screws when you're trying to rebuild. They just drive me nuts.
I don't mind them, but, you know, some people, you know, if you don't have those Allen keys right handy, I always do because just the way I roll. But yeah, you can't just grab one of the handy dandy blue screwdrivers and go to town. You've got to have the right key available. I find them really nice, but You gotta have the tool available. Nate says it looks like they're not milled in. Yes, you can see a line, but I'm just trying to figure out, is that line actually a break, or is that the line where one plane becomes another plane? And I'm just not sure. If they are not milled in, I will say this, they've done a much nicer, neater job on this than some of the other clones I've seen. So either way, I'll find out. And I will let you know.
Okay, now I have one dripper. Now this one's become very popular, and I believe this is going to start. This is the next generation, in my opinion, and this is called the Derringer. Everybody's heard it. It's the Derringer style. So this is on eBay. Now the beauty of this is you're getting the Derringer and you're getting all five caps with it. You're getting the white Delrin and the black, the brass, the copper, and the stainless steel tops.
Cool.
Now it's only $16.55, free shipping. Now I know Scope, who's a co-host here on Mon Envy and also a host on the show Before the Swirling Out, loves his Derringer. And I think this is the next level when it comes to drippers, where they're staying 22mm with the shortening limit. And what that does is it gives it an automatic chamber reducer. And, you know, it's from what he told me, it's extremely easy to build. And, of course, now they're smaller, they're cheaper. Because they're not using as much materials. That's why they can do the things like give you all the caps and all that stuff for just $16.55. Also, there is a competition cap out there for these floating around. I believe Vapor DNA has one. They're kind of expensive because they're legit competition caps. I think like $20. But what it does is it takes that cap that you see covering it and puts a big old chuff kind of Delrin drip tip on it. And it, from my understanding, just makes everything even more insane. And that is that. All right.
Well, I have one more. We've been really working
hammering away.
Yeah, we're on point. Like 10:14, and I'm coming up on my last deal here. But let's share it. This one was kind of cool. Now, this is up on the blog already, but I wanted to give you guys, you know, first advance notice of this one. So I did not do the social media rollout on it yet, so it's a little bit still of a secret. And let me grab my link. There it
is. I like this thing.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting, I think. But let's show the people the picture. They're calling this the Vapefly Vippo. Now, I wonder where that name comes from. Of course, reminiscent of a Zippo lighter in its styling with that flip top. If you're sick and tired of taking something with you and then picking pocket lint or purse, schmutz out of the drip tip, this is the answer. This one's going to travel beautifully with you, protect that drip tip. The atomizer fits right down into the unit. You can see here it's kind of a long, skinny little puppy that just screws right down into there. The only thing that pokes out is the drip tip. The lid flips over the whole thing shut, and then you've got just the little fire button right here to let her rip. Four lights on it let you know your battery level, and it's just going to be a really cute little, in a pinch, stealth vape, I'm thinking. So. Well, water skiing, Big Bamboo, I wouldn't recommend, like, this is not waterproof. There are mods out there that are, but certainly something that's going to, you know, be very, very practical for pocket or purse and smaller and stealthier than a lot of setups.
Right. I think it's cool looking.
Well, you know what a big fan I am of those e-cigos that, help me out with the name of the vendor again, Joe.
Vapage?
That's the one, Vapage, the e-cigo from Vapage, and it's, of course, just that little Zippo lighter fill-in, and, you know, my favorite trick is to snap it open, but this is a little bit sturdier. It's going to deliver a little bit more vape, I'm thinking, because, of course, the e-cigo is just a cartomizer setup, And you know, $28.99, you get everything you need in the box, including a ribbon cable for your USB. So all in all, it's kind of a neat little fun device.
Yeah, I think that thing is really neat, really cool looking, unique.
You know how you catch a unique rabbit, Joe?
How?
Unique up on it.
Oh God. Oh, terrible. Oh.
Ashley knew. Ashley saw that one coming. How do you catch a tame rabbit, Ashley? The same way. Came way. Unique up on it. I love it. Thank you. No, I know part two.
How do you catch it? You hit it in the head with a fucking shovel. Jersey way.
Oh.
I'm only kidding. Oh. Well, why do you want to catch the rabbit? You want to eat it, right?
No, you want to play with it because it's soft and cuddly.
Okay, so I've saved the best deal for last. This is one hell of a deal, and this is coming from our friends over at Yeti Vape. He hit me up the other day. He's like, Joe, I want to put something on your vlog. I said, well, it's got to be good, you know? He goes, well, I want to sell the jellyfish. I said, well, jellyfishes are expensive. He goes, well, how about this? We're going to do a jellyfish mod and 120 mils of juice for $99. Now, a jellyfish itself goes for about 130 bucks. They're made by the people who do Vape Case, by Oscar over at Lotus EC. I have a jellyfish. These things hit hard. They're 53 watts, but I think they hit a lot harder than 53 watts. Now, with this, it has its own internal 4,000 mAh battery, okay, which is more than enough to last you all day, okay? And, of course, it also does, like, you can charge your phone and stuff, other stuff like that, I believe. But the cool thing, again, you get 120 mils of Yeti juice with this, too. So, basically, if you were, you know, a good price on 120 mils, I think Toxic has one deal going now. It's like 20 bucks for 120 mils. That's cheap, but let's just say, on average, 120 mils of juice is like 40 bucks. You're paying $59.99 for a jellyfish, which is more than cost. I'm cheaper than cost. So what this guy has put together is an incredible, incredible deal. And you guys should really check it out. I have one. They're great. And the display on these things, I think it's got the finest display in the industry, to be quite honest with you.
Nice.
So for those of you who are looking for a heart, what's up, Hunter?
Well, I know you've had great experience with yours, and it's been going well, and you're really enjoying it. But to be fair, Joe, and we should mention it, and Ark Redneck did bring it up in the room, the jellyfish is not getting great reviews, and I've heard a number of less than positive reviews. But it might depend on the user or on the unit itself, because I know yours has been solid.
Yeah, mine's been solid. It does hit harder than 53 watts, but see, it has settings, and people don't realize it. There's a soft, a moderate, and a powerful setting. You can add, like, you could set it to 53 watts and powerful, and it's gonna blow your mouth out. So it's, you gotta remember the soft, the moderate, and the people are just hitting the wattage and going, okay, boom, but it may be on the powerful setting. And that's the one where it gives an extra boost. Personally, I don't understand why they do it. I believe the SX Mini still has that too, doesn't it? Doesn't it have like a powerful, moderate, and whatever
setting? Yes, it does, but the SX Mini, I think, is a little more accurate. And Purple Easy, that's kind of what it comes down to for the price, you know?
Yeah.
So maybe you have to set it at 40 to get 45. You know, my feeling is the numbers are really irrelevant. You just keep inching up or inching down until you find the sweet spot, and that's where you vape. I don't really care what the number is, you know?
I can't believe I'm quoting him, but, you know, I love the guy. But Grim Green said it best. This is a long time ago. He goes, I'm not a numbers guy. I'm a taste guy. I just dial it in, and then I vape. And I don't care what it could say, 5 billion watts. Doesn't matter, as long as it's working for what I put on it. So what if the jellyfish says 6 watts and it's blowing your mouth out? You know, or you set it to, you know, 16 watts and it's your perfect setting? It doesn't matter, as long as the mod works for you.
Yeah.
And again, if I was selling a jellyfish for $139 retail, I'd be like, no, don't buy it, because there's so much you could get for $139. But for 99 plus 120 mils of juice, that's a great deal. A really, really, really great deal. And that's about, that's it for my deals. But we have about 10 minutes.
We have 8 minutes left to the bottom of the hour. So do you want to throw it open to questions?
Oh, yeah, sure. Absolutely.
All right.
Anybody have any questions about them? I'm rocking at about 120 in the room at 1:30 on a Tuesday. How about that? Well, now Wednesday for me.
Oh, Big Bam wants to know about the 91%, the Russian deal you had.
If you want to put it up, I sure put it up. Mount Baker Vapor. I don't know, because, you know, K-Fun style vapes, I don't know how popular they are anymore. But when I put this up, because an original 91% version 2, for $44 over at Mount Baker Vapor. Now, for those of you who are into legits, it's extremely, thank you, Big Vamp. It's a great deal. These were going for $100, $115, $120 at one point. You could get the full regalia for just $44.99 over at Mount Baker Vapor for the stainless steel. They also have the black and the shiny, which is just a little bit more expensive. But for the price, and for those of you into K-Fun vapes, those of you into legits, you're going to get it at a really, really, really cheap price. Because I remember pimping these at $110 at one point. So.
Now, there was another question in the room. I was wondering if you knew. Someone is looking, Leadhead is looking for the Hellboy RDA. Now, I know I've seen them, but I'm not sure who's carrying them now. Do you happen to know offhand?
The Hellboy. Those I haven't seen. They're like a squarish kind of. They're a square kind of Addy, I believe.
Square,
right?
RDA, yeah.
Yeah, I haven't seen them anywhere, to be honest with you. I've seen pictures. I'm sure they haven't been. I don't believe they've been cloned yet. I'm not saying they should be, but I'm saying I don't think they've been cloned yet. So I'm thinking, you know, the legit sites may have them, like Vape Rev and all those other guys. Let's see.
Easy Bus is saying he saw on eBay. Oh, and Big Bam has the link. Thank you, Big Bam.
Oh, there it is. Let's see.
Oh, and my apologies. Toxic was there with it too. Sorry.
Yeah, they have it in black only for $119.99, and they're out of stock. They'll have more in midweek April. So, if you want the black one, buy it, pre-order it, and you're good to go. That's what you were looking for. Big Bam Boom has found it.
Condi, I will check my IMs out when the show is over. It's difficult for me to monitor them during the broadcast.
All right, now, any other questions out there? We have about 5 minutes, and then DC's coming in to take over for the wee hours of the morning.
You betcha. Oh, there's a group buy in Facebook for $80 on the Hellboy. Thank you, Fox Shadowbox. And there's DC. Hi, DC.
Oh, there it is.
Okay.
Beautiful. So, Tiger.
So, Joe.
So, Tiger, when are you expecting your zero? Is it coming anytime soon?
Well, let's check the tracking. One of my favorite things to do. Oh, look, there's new tracking events. I've got notifications. Something's
this girl
moving.
Is a tracking Nazi. She's a tracking Nazi.
It's true. It's absolutely true. Oh, wow. Okay, well, some things are moving quick. Others, not so much. Let's just see here. Where is that? It is somewhere between... I think it's somewhere in the Pacific Ocean right now. Yes. That's what I think, because it says it was sent to a Pacific processing center, and that was on the 23rd. But I haven't got any tracking events since then, so we shall find out. Who knows? Maybe
okay.
Tomorrow
well, right
I'll
now they're
find
on
out
a,
it's here.
It's on a garbage barge right now, making its way over.
That's right.
Joe, any opinions on the zero box mods? Yeah, we talked about the beginning. Tiger got me one of these beautiful puppies. Just on a whim, because she's, you know, good to me like that. And it's a great mod. Awesome. I've been using it all day.
Let me share that deal with you guys, too, because I got his, and I agonized for a while, and it's like, do I need one, too? And I really agonized about it for a while, and then I finally decided that, yes, in fact, I did need one, too. So if you find yourself also needing one, too... And Big Bam is there with it. There we go. Okay, well, thank you, Big Bam.
Yeah, and don't forget, these covers come off. So you can buy the covers on Fastech. You could buy the aluminum. You could buy the gold. They have green and purple and blue. They have all different kinds of covers. These you could switch out. You just take, mm-hmm. I believe you take these two top and bottom pins off, and off it comes. So, but I don't think I'll be removing this, because I like the black and mother of pearl look on this. It's really
yeah.
nice.
Cool. Well, and yours is so unique because it's almost got two different looks on the different sides.
Yeah, I have this side, and then I have this side. And if you look down the side here, you can actually see your battery that goes like showing through it. So it gives it like a, you know, if I put a green battery in there, it'd be green on the side or whatever. So really,
cool.
Really
I didn't
nice one
realize there was that much translucence in it. That's kind of cool.
$58, guys, and it says sex on it. I swear it says sex.
Says you.
Look at the picture. It's
I'm
so
waiting
sex
for it to show up. I didn't think that's what it looked like.
It says sex. At least that's what I'm. It's my story. I'm sticking to it.
Well, I think it's SB. It's SXK is what it is. It's SXK, silly man.
It's sex. That's all I'm saying. It's sex. That means that's sex in Chinese. Damn it.
Don't listen to him. It's SXK.
Don't listen to her.
Ashley says I did it on purpose. I'll never tell.
Future Mr. Donnie Jr. Mr. Donnie Jr. Those are the bell caps for, I believe, the, those are for the Kangers. And they're gorgeous, and there's only one man in the world making them.
That's not Danny Jr. That's the future Mrs. Downey Jr. That's Mrs. Iron Man to you, buddy.
Oh, my bad. Anyway,
go girl.
They're very, very hard to find. He actually makes us custom stuff for the K-Films too, so he's the only one doing it. He never has them in stock.
So M. Jarman wants to know, you've had both in hand, what do you recommend more, the Zero or the Jellyfish?
Oh, you know, he just found them. Oh, the Zero.
Big Bam is, like, utterly amazing. Yes.
Yeah,
you'll
yes,
just
but
find anything.
Okay, the difference, though, I believe, Big Bam, is the ones he makes are actually glass. These seem to be acrylic, which I guess if you want them to use them, just don't get any tank crackers. Don't put any fluid in there. You'll find yourself with a melty, melty tank.
Good point,
damn,
Danimal. Good point, Danimal. On the Zero, you can change the battery. That's one of the things. I love my box mods, but when they're tired, you have to plug them in and walk away for a while. I do like a mod that you can drop the battery out and just replace it with a charged one if you want to. It's nice to have. I love USB charging. It's so convenient and so easy. But sometimes you just want to keep vaping and going. So I love the option of dropping a battery.
Yes, yes. Okay, the time is 1:30.
It is,
this went
in
quick.
In fact, I've got, we're 1 minute past, and DC is ready to rock and roll. So DC, we're going to turn the room over to you, and we're going to leave all you guys in the very, very capable hands of our wonderful late night host. He'll be taking you on through until the coffee's on or until he's so tired he can't keep his eyes open, whichever comes first. So have
all right,
a
guys,
great
so we'll
night. Thanks for being here with us.
We'll see you next week.
Next week. All right. Nighty night.
Bye, guys.